Hey folks, you're here with Red Carpet Report. I'm Cory Ringdahl, and we are at the 21st Annual Actors Fund Tony Awards Viewing Party here in lovely Los Angeles, California.
How are you?
Good, how are you?
What's your name?
My name's Cory.
Hi, how are you?
Hi, good. We'll just greet each other for the rest of the evening.
Well, I think we should, you know, it makes it better.
It really does. This way we'll never not know who we are.
That's true.
Perfect. So are you rooting for anyone in particular this evening for the Tonys?
I am rooting for it to be equally distributed so that as many shows as possible can stay running. Because I think it's hard when there's always a rout, you know, because then five or six shows will close within a month. And I don't want to see that happen. I would like to see, you know, there are shows that are safe to run for a while and there are shows that are not. And I want them to get the biggest commercial they can possibly get and have audiences flock to them.
That is the most diplomatic and pragmatic answer to my question. I have to retire it now, and it's all your fault.
Well, I mean, I'm rooting for everybody. It's. I mean, there's so many great people. You hate to see somebody, you know, somebody lose, somebody, who knows. So I'm happy for everybody.
So I guess tell me your history with the Actors Fund.
I have fortunately not required their assistance personally, but many of my friends have, and I've donated to them throughout my career because I think they're essential for actors in need and that they are so inspiring, and it's like having a safety net. And especially in the country now, today, the way things are with healthcare and the safety net sort of falling away, the Actors Fund is really important. The work they do is extremely important, and we have to take care of each other.
Excellent. And how many, I guess, what types of events have you been to? You've been to the Tony viewing event before.
No, this is my first time.
This is your first time.
It is. I'm very excited.
You are very excited.
I usually watch at home on TV, and so I'm very excited to be here.
I'm sorry you couldn't bring your blanket and your cat, but...
my cat likes theater, so he's a big fan.
What was the first play that you were in, play or musical, that you were in that made you feel like a professional actor?
Well, my first job that I was paid for was at the New London Barn Playhouse in New Hampshire. And we did summer stock, like a play a week and then a musical every 2 weeks. So every week you were doing a new one. So we did a play for a week, then a play for a week, and then a musical every 2 weeks. This was hard. But I played Annie Oakley in Annie Get Your Gun, and Casey Nicholaw directed it. And I got paid $25 a week and room and board. But we had to work, too. So we worked in the shop, and we worked building sets and painting things. And one of the jobs was picking up the cigarette butts from the driveway.
I'm a host.
It's very glamorous. But then at night, I got to play Annie Oakley. And I played Meg Brockie in Brigadoon. And I played Jean Brody in The Prime of Miss Jean Brody, the tender age of 20. So it was a good season.
Fantastic. Well, thank you very much for your time and your enthusiasm this evening.
Well, thank you. It's my pleasure.
Absolutely. Thank you very much. Hey folks, this is Cory. Thank you so much for watching us here on Red Carpet Report. Hope you enjoyed seeing the Tonys this year. If you like what you saw, give us a like, subscribe definitely to see more of this again, and leave a comment today. Who did you want to win this year? Why? Did you really want them to fight to the death? Maybe they will, just for you.